So in the town of Ulthar lived a cotter and his wife, and the townsfolk presumably thought that they disliked cats for one reason or another. And because of this, cats would go missing in the town to the point where people were afraid to let their cats outside due to the fact that the cotter and their wife and his wife may be in fact killing cats. One day, strangers came to the town who worshipped Egyptian gods and would pray to them at night, and the youngest of the group of followers lost his cat, at which point they prayed, and eventually the cats and the strange travelers disappeared. And another thing that happened was that when the townsfolk visited the cotter and his wife at some point or another, all they found were bones. Eventually, all the cats returned to the town, and they all seemed quite full for the last or the few couple days they got there. In the game, The Cats of Ulthar, you're playing a two-player game of cat and mouse. You're trying to play cats down and hopefully be able to kill the cotter and his wife that are trying to hurt the cats. As you play cards down, the cotter and the wife will presumably do certain things to deal with those cats, and if you can play all your cats down in time, you win the game by annihilating that evil, evil couple that likes to kill poor, poor kitties. It is a game that takes about 20 to 30 minutes, and it's for ages 13 and up. Let's go ahead and take a look down below at The Cats of Ulthar. So here we have the game The Cats of Ulthar and everything included. And as you can see, you're going to get the box for the game, the rule book, you're going to get three different types of cards, the Ancient Elder God cards, the player cards, and the Cotter and Wife cards. Additionally, there's an individual Cotter and Wife card that's set in the middle of the table. And you're going to give each player a youngest player card or an oldest player card. And you're going to set it on the left and right hand side of the Cotter and Wife. The youngest player will play with the youngest player card and the oldest will play with the oldest player card. After which, everybody's going to get four cards in their hand from the player card deck, and they're going to begin the game. This is pretty much all set up for the two players, and you're going to basically play a card from your hand and then draw a card. When you play a cat card, you're going to draw a cotter and a wife card and see what happens. And if you play a spell card, if you annihilate another player's cat, you're going to have to deal with ancient elder gods. But otherwise, you're just simply trying to place a cat in each of these three areas, and then play a specific kill card to destroy the cotter and wife. If you can do that, you win the game, The Cats of Ulthar. Let's go ahead and take it down below, and I will show you how to play the game. So here we have the game, The Cats of Ulthar, and it's set up for two players. The oldest player over here, the youngest player over here, and everybody's got four cards in their hand. And we're going to go ahead and start with this player here, randomly chosen, and they're going to get to play a cat. That's what we're going to do. We're going to put right there. In general, cats are going to only be placed on the symbols that match. If they don't have a symbol, that usually means that it is a mystic cat, and mystic cats are wild. And if you can place all your cats around here and then play a kill card, that will defeat or destroy the cotter and wife. Additionally, whenever you play a cat card, you have to draw a cotter and a wife card because they're going to try and hurt the poor kitties. Murky Waters, the oldest player's cat in slot one, is drowned. Uh-oh, and this cat's not protected by drowning, so we have to look in our hand. Oh, we actually have a protection spell, and it shows right here, Elemental Deflection, which means that we can protect against Murky Waters with this card. So we're going to go ahead and do that, discarding both of the cards and saving the cat. Additionally, he's going to end his turn by drawing up to his hand size. Next player's turn is the youngest spellcaster, and they're going to look at their hand, and they can play any cat as long as it's in the right field. And we have a black cat here, which is an orange too. These match, so you can place that there. We'll draw another cotter and wife card and see what happens. Night Terrors, the oldest cat in slot one, is eaten by wolves. Uh-oh. Well, luckily, a black cat is also not only mystic and wild, but it says black cats always evade wolves, so the mystic cat can be fielded anywhere. So it's going to evade the Night Terrors, protecting it from being eaten. Nice. I like that black cat. He's very, very useful. This player is then going to get to draw a card back to his hand, and once again, it'll be this player's turn. He's got the kill card here, which means if he ever gets these three slots filled in, he can play this card on that cotter and wife and win the game, but right now we still need more cats and we don't have any more. So we're going to look at some cards here. This one says, without looking at the faces of your opponent's cards, you can pick one to keep. Your opponent then draws a card from the deck, or sorry, from the player's cards deck to keep.
Okay, so we're going to go ahead and play this card here and draw a card. And this player is going to go ahead and take another card. And that is going to end this player's turn. No cat was played, so no Cotter and Wife is played. Let's go ahead and look at this player's hand. We do have a Furless Sphinx, so we can place that card right there. It does match the symbols with the one. So another cat is going to be drawn from the Cotter and Wife card is going to be drawn. Evil Swine, the oldest player's cat in slot 3, is going to be fed to the pigs. Remove the card and send it to the discard pile. There is no cat there, so the Cotter and the Wife do not get to feed any cats to pigs, which is always good, right? And one more, let's do one more turn. Okay, so now it's this player's turn. They've got some magic deflection, and this levitation spell. Opponent's fielded cat of your choice is mashed into a tree. Remove the cat card and send that player to the discard pile. So we'll go ahead and play on this cat here, thusly discarding this card. And this poor kitty, as long as there's no protection in this player's hand from it, actually this one would protect it, I think, but we're going to go ahead and pretend like he can't protect it, thusly sending the cat to the discard pile. Because what happens is when you kill a cat and you are not the Cotter and the Wife, you have to draw an Ancient Elder God card and do what it says. This is Gog Shabaf, and this one says that the cat killer must remove all of their fielded mystic cats and send them to the discard pile. So there's a cost to killing cats in this game, and then you're going to discard the god card there, in which case you draw back to your hand size and continue the game. And that's pretty much the idea of it. If you can get cats for all of your slots, and I'll go ahead and just show you what that would look like. One there, two matches that. This is a three that would match there. And then let's see if we can find a mystic cat for this slot here. In which case, if it was this player's turn and he had all three of those, he could play this card there, eliminating the poor, poor Cotter and his wife, and winning the game, the Cats of Ulthar. Okay, let's come up and talk about it.
The Cats of Ulthar is basically a two-player take-that card game with tableau management. You're trying to place your cats down, you're trying to defeat the cobbler and his wife, but your opponent is also trying to do the same thing and they want to do it first. Now, of course, you want to protect cats, and you don't want your cats to be killed by the cotter and his wife. However, you may want to take care of your opponent's cats to keep them from gaining the all-powerful ability to kill the cotter. And that is going to run consequences. The Ancient Elder God cards, these guys here, do things to you for your sacrilege of destroying poor innocent kitties. And that's basically the idea of it all. If you can do what you need to do to the poor cotter, then you have succeeded. And if you can't, well, then your opponent's going to be very happy. And the ancient Egyptian gods will be smiling in favor upon them. This game is, I think, based on an H.P. Lovecraft book, and it does feel like a Cthulhu-style game. It's got that crazy artwork. I really, really dig the artwork for this game. It's got some really cool visual artwork. Very dark, and I wouldn't say it's necessarily too dark. Well, it's pretty close. For any of you cat lovers out there, this game might be a tad over the top for you, because, yes, you're trying to protect cats, until sometimes when you're not, like levitating a cat and throwing it into a tree, or potentially vaporizing cats. And the cotter and the wife is also doing stuff like that. So this is not really for little kids. It's also not super, it is strategic. You do get to choose between the four cards in your hand, but I wouldn't say it's as complex as something like a worker placement or whatnot. This is obviously a take that card game, so you have those options in your hand, and how you want to kind of utilize the cards and where you want to play them and when you want to play them is going to matter, but I wouldn't say it's super, super deep in strategy. However, it is super, super deep in theme, and I, as a dog lover, don't mind this game whatsoever. It's a lot of fun, and I enjoy the fact that you're moving around and choosing how you want to place your cats and whether or not it's worth risking the wrath of the ancient Egyptian gods and destroying your opponent's cat, or just hoping that they don't have the kill card in their hand, because you can only have one kill card in your hand. If you draw another one, you're going to lose it. So you have to play. You basically limit yourself with having that kill card, but you also really, really need it. So it's kind of this back and forth thing. Maybe you don't have one, so you're trying to pull it from your opponent's hand. It has some tactical choices in the game as to when you want to play certain cards or whether you want to keep certain protections. If you can't play anything, you can discard a card and draw a card, and you can kind of manipulate the game in this interesting way. So I like that aspect of the game. It's definitely different than a lot of the take that card games I'm used to. Most of them just have a single deck and you draw and you play and you draw and you play. This one, it's the same style as that, but it's got different types of decks that do different things. And in fact, not only that, but like the Cotter and the Wife card deck is actually going to have oldest player, youngest player cards. And when you flip those over, you're going to actually replace your old one with this new one, and that might make the cats disappear because they're no longer loyal to you, which is, I kind of think, what the theme is of the game, right? But overall, a satisfying game. Really enjoyed this one. As long as you don't mind the deep, dark theme of this game, the fact that you are killing animals, I mean, that is kind of part of the theme of it. It's that dark, deep, Cthulian, Lovecraftian style, and I personally dig it. However, I can understand people saying, nah, it's a little too dark for me. As far as any, like, gameplay mechanical issues, I didn't really see a lot of them. As long as you make sure that you read the cards and you play them down. So, for instance, that black cat tabby, first time we did the video, I didn't read the fact that it said that it's not eaten by wolves. So I was like, well, what's happening? And, oh, it's not supposed to die. Okay, that's awesome. So there are certain cats that have certain protections. And then, of course, certain cats that are going to be easier to play but not be as useful, and cards that are harder to play but are more likely to stay on the field. All these kind of things thrown in. The Ancient Elder Gods, I'll go ahead and read a couple of them for you before we end this up. Sebuk Lundrak, it says that the cat killer has a the cat killer has a Kotar and a wife card in their hand. They must trade it with their opponent for a card of opponent's choosing. Wow, so that's not very good for you. Must discard all their Siamese cats from the field and send them to the discard pile. Killer must discard all cards in their hand and replace them with four new cards. Well, that might be good or bad, depending on what you have. If you lose that kill card, it's going to be difficult to win. Discard a spell card from their hand if they have one, and pull the next card from the player deck. So some of these are obviously more dangerous than others. Personally, my favorite thing about the game is obviously the theme of it. It's really rich in themes, specifically for a two-player card game, as well as the fact that it's got a lot more strategical nature than most of the card games I'm used to when it comes to take that card games. Definitely would recommend for any of you guys who like the Lovecraftian based games, specifically those who really like the artwork style of that type of theme. Definitely something to take a look at it down below in the description. If you think you want to destroy some Kotar and wives, go ahead and pick up the Cats of Ulthar. It's a fun little game. Alright guys, thanks for watching another Unfiltered Gamer board game review of the game The Cats of Ulthar, when you're trying to destroy some Kotars and wives. I like it. It's fun. Something you guys should check out. It's kind of weird. Like, what's the audience? The audience is obviously Cthulian, Lovecraftian based fans, but not too young of kids because of the theme. Probably not the huge heavy gamer, so it's like this mid-range of people that love artwork and love the theme and something that's quick and easy to play. As well as taking a look at unfilteredgamer.com. That's a blog post, giveaways, Kickstarter lists, and more. Giving away two games right now, Raid Boss, as well as the game, ooh, what is the other game we're giving away? Oh, Invader Zim from IDW. You can take a look at those games, tweet, try and get yourself a chance to win. Also, our live stream every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. PST, we're giving away a bunch of games, and it's a lot of fun. I got my little sign here, Unfiltered Gamer Live, come check us out. We totally love more people, and we want to spread the love for games. It's probably, I'd say it's probably one of the top live streams right now on Facebook. Also, you can check out our friends, everythingboardgames.com and The Giveaway Geek. They give away a ton of great stuff, and they are wonderful friends to have. If you want, you can support us on Patreon. Go ahead and check out the link down below. Patreon supporters, you get a bunch of cool little things based on our live stream. And we also do some interesting individual content regarding game mechanics, theme, playstyle, all that kind of stuff. We're doing a series right there. And exclusive looks on games that haven't come out yet that you haven't seen that I won't release until a week after. So if you're interested in that kind of content, do go ahead and check it out. It's only $1 if you really want. All right, thanks guys. As always, I look forward to hopefully not having to kill any cats next time.